Hello and welcome to part two of our Game of Thrones special week. I'm Tori.
I'm Samwell Tarly. You can listen to Skyrim Storyteller. You can read about it in a book, but listen to it.
Today we're going to be going over some of the... So last week we sort of established the world. We brought you into Westeros, and now we're going to be diving into some of the iconic parts of Game of Thrones and of Westeros.
Kind of the look of it, more so. Like, so this episode is really just going to be like a Westeros aesthetic in terms of, like, armor and weapons. Like, we wanted to show off, like, some of the assets that you can bring in to make it more Game of Thrones-like.
Yeah, it's going to be... We're going to be showing... It's going to be Westeros' next top model.
Yeah.
Sort of kind of thing. But really cool stuff on the docket. I'm excited to get into it. So, Tyler, let's get right into it. That was redundant. So, Tyler, we find ourselves in a place we genuinely do not visit very often, which is...
No, not at all.
No, it's going to be Windhelm.
It feels right, like a big dining hall, stone castle, like that Game
sort
of Thrones
feel. Like that hardy
stone. That Winterfell-like feeling. And that is in Windhelm, and we don't come here for that motherfucker.
No, we are not a fan of him, but we are a fan of some good-looking armors.
Exactly. That's what we did with our first mod. It's Game of Thrones armor, and it rips the armor sets right out of the show, and they look so fucking good. It looks like they were just scanned just right there, and I cannot believe how good they look.
Yes.
Like, this is Arya's traveler suit.
Yep, the iconic look for Arya, I would say.
For, like, seasons 2 to 4, she was wearing this, and it looks so good. Like, the belts, the whole tunic, like, the way it's shaped around and how it comes to the neck, like, it looks so good.
Yeah, even the undershirt and everything. Like, it's just, it's
perfect.
It's so good.
So what we kind of wanted to do with
this... Oh, hold on, let me say, Game of Thrones armor, that is the name of this mod. Game of Thrones armor.
Yeah, so what we kind of wanted to do with this is, as opposed to just, like, reading it off, just showing you all of the available options you can pick from the show, because there are
dozens.
A lot.
Dozens.
So we're going to be kind of like cutting around here, just showing off the different armor sets.
Yes, we are.
So this was Arya's. Let's try like an actual armor set now.
Yeah, let's get into it.
So this is the cuirass of Storm's End.
Yes, it is.
You see that nice gold plating and that kind of orangish leather look to
the armor.
Yeah,
sort of like quilted look almost to it.
Yeah, exactly. So that's what you were going to see like Robert Baratheon in and like... The conquest of the Targaryens and everything.
Right, the sort of the people
like
of Storm's
Robert's
End,
Rebellion.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's what you're going to kind of see them wearing. We've seen it in season one, like that quilted pattern that they were wearing with that gold accent for the shoulder pads. And oh my fucking God, it looks amazing.
Yeah, it does. What else we got?
This is the exiled Northern cuirass. Again, they do this so perfectly with like that belt loop.
And if you don't know, this is Jorah, if you don't know.
Exactly. So this is going to be what Jorah wears pretty much all the fucking time until he like takes his armor off.
Yeah, I mean, if he's ever ready for battle, he puts on his armor. This is what Jorah looks like. Underneath, you can see he's got like the kind of classic yellow shirt that he wears.
Yeah. I love it. Like it.
Yep.
It looks like it could come out of Skyrim, like that steel plate armor. But there's just that extra detail about it that is just so... I don't know how they did these so well.
Yeah,
this must have taken so much time.
Yeah, super good.
This is definitely recognizable as the armor the Hound wears.
Yeah, and it's perfect. It's
that perfect, like, what is that? Is it like heavy leather kind of going down?
Yeah, I don't know. He's got like the little like plates sort of that go down the armor and stuff. And then, of course, like the solid neck plate and the shoulder pads and everything, like... The Hound, I feel like the Hound's armor, because he never changes pretty much ever.
No.
You only see him in that. And so that's one of the most iconic armors because it is, it's like a defining feature of his character.
Yeah, it's remained throughout the entire series. And
there's sometimes
little issues with like...
It's so minor.
It's so minor. You will never, like when you look at this is so much better than any armor set you're going to find in this game. Like
it's
looks
wild
so
how
detailed.
Good it looks. Yeah, it's great.
Oh my God. And you just want to call someone a cunt when you're wearing this. Like that's just all there is to it.
Lots of cunts.
Wait, this is this like a fan casting kind of thing we're doing right now? Arya in the Hound's armor?
Oh my god.
Is this a fan moment that we're doing? Are we doing fan service?
I don't want to be doing it, but like if it's going to get us views, you know?
Potential money? No, that all the money would have been taken with that intro. We used that. We ripped that music.
That is true. We cannot monetize this episode at all. But let's see what else we got in the
war chest. Oh, this one is very good. This is the Iron Islands, just kind of their under armor. This is like what Yara would wear.
Yep.
What Theon would wear.
Mm-hmm. Yep. And I think that is Yara's outfit. I think that's where they took that
because it's. It looks so perfect. Again, yeah. I don't know what else to say
this
about
this.
This
is
going to
be just a
like,
series of us going, it's perfect. It's perfect.
Well, I mean, just the amount of like attention to detail. Like you see like that, those dotted, like it's armored. It's like slightly armored. Mm. Yep. Some controller problems again. The armor look, the ties around the front.
Yep.
They're all belted how they are in the show and like how it rises up like on the waist. Like it doesn't fully cover the butt like a lot of the cuirasses
do. It doesn't go long. It's like a...
It's very short. It's like their casual wear. And it's so good.
It's great.
This is my shit right here.
Yeah.
It's probably one of the worst lookings just because
unfortunately.
The black is really hard to replicate in game.
Yeah.
And so is that very distinct like... That neck piece can't connect to a shoulder pad. It's just one piece.
Right.
So that's got to be really hard to do. But this is Jon's King's cuirass.
Yes, it is.
So this is kind of what he's wearing in later. Yeah, no spoilers, but like as you go on, that's kind of what he starts wearing.
Right. And I believe this is the one that Armad on Tuesday was wearing as well. I think
exactly.
He uses this armor.
Yeah, and obviously this is like a different model.
Right. It's still cool, but I think a lot of these are sort of intended to fit on male characters, but they all look good.
I was just gonna say, I do want to point out that like they're definitely intended for male characters. But what's so impressive is that even the female character model in Skyrim can wear these without any weird clipping, without any weird like.
Yeah.
It doesn't look that weird. Like sure, they're bulkier, but it's armor. You would imagine
it's going to be a little bit heavier.
Although this stuff does come up to her neck, so it looks like she just doesn't have a neck.
It's a turtleneck. John wears a turtleneck.
That is canon.
Yeah, it's a canonized turtleneck. Band name, I call it.
Fuck, you're really getting those recently.
King Renly's armor.
Yep.
False King Renly.
The usurper.
Yeah.
Renly Baratheon. Oh my god, I didn't notice that before. It's got the
stag.
The stag's mounted, and he's got that nice, pretty gold armor because he was pretty. Renly is very pretty.
He's a beautiful man.
He's a beautiful boy.
Son of a bitch.
Another thing I want to point out is the attention to detail in this.
Yep.
With the embossing that the armors have, like replicating that. Like, look at this next one. This is Stannis's armor, and it's got that burning stag.
Yeah. And not only that, it made hard enough to do like all the chainmail with the little bits of armor he has kind of pieced on there, but then having the burning stag head of Stannis's sort of like
new house sigil.
It's just such faithful recreations of the armors. It's mind blowing because
I don't know how they made those individual like patches.
Yeah, these are like entirely new models. I don't know if they ripped them from some type of Game of Thrones game or if someone just cares enough to really put in the work.
To replicate so deeply.
Yeah.
Like, because this isn't just like one texture armor set.
No.
Look at all of that like intricate chainmail with then like the armor pads like sewn into it.
And like the back, it has like the little leather strips. Like it's very, very detailed.
And, like, the buckling as well.
Yep.
That is in an incredible amount of detail. And I know this person is not the mod creator. They ported it, I believe.
Yeah.
Nexus.
Yeah, I believe it was a port, yeah.
So whoever originally made it on Nexus, or whoever made any of these models, so good. Love it so much.
Oh, no. This is the guy. Pies don't go. This is the person who made it. It's not a port.
Oh. So. You are fucking incredible.
Nope, never mind. It's a port. Sorry.
See, I
missed the one line. God damn it.
Another iconic one.
Of course.
The Kingsguard.
Yeah. You look a little portly in this one.
You do look... Well, I mean, the Kingsguard is pretty portly. And you got the...
They're all fat fucks. Just say
the white cloak.
Yep.
And again, that embossing. Yeah. And the detail on the arms, like how it's kind of scaly.
Yeah, it's got that the kind of like shimmering, like sequined armor.
Yeah, it's really weird, but they look so good.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, definitely is the portliest.
Like if you're trying to set armor. A mood for Game of Thrones, this is like straight direct copies, and it's nothing's gonna make your game feel more like it than
inspired
this.
Inspired by Game of Thrones, this is a perfect replica.
This is, you want Game of Thrones, gimme now.
Gimme.
Let me have some.
And this is your Loras armor.
Another beautiful man. We gotta say it. We gotta admit it.
Very handsome.
Yeah.
And he's got that longer, flowing armor at the bottom, but then all those like flower details.
Mm-hmm. Now, Tyler, do all of these armors, especially his, I'm curious, does it come with the helmet too? Are we just not wearing it?
Some of them do not have helmets. So a lot of these do not. So,
okay.
Some of them, like the Storm's End one does, and then
the more
basic
guard armor
The basic guard armor, but like if the character isn't wearing a helmet, then there isn't a helmet.
Okay.
I did not see the Hound's helmet because I was looking for
that. That would have been really cool.
But he hardly ever wears it.
Right. He wore it like twice.
And God, this one I think might be my favorite, just in terms of like the detail and like how
his armor
was
known for being the most detailed and flashiest. Yeah, and the way it has the chainmail that kind of hangs down in the three spikes in the front, and it's beautifully done.
It's very beautiful work, and I cannot see anything wrong with the model, like any clipping.
No,
the back is even like beautifully lit. Like look how the light shines off of that specific part.
I know,
like
it's wild.
Detailed work.
Wild.
This one doesn't really make sense to me all that much because it is fitted for the female
body. It's one of the few ones that actually has the female variant of it.
Yeah, which it might just be the only one that, like, when you make it, it assigns the
body model. Maybe like it looks like the Akaviri, maybe.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But, I mean, the helmet is perfect. That looks like it. I mean, the armor is perfect. I mean, it's just you're not used to seeing
sort of different, yeah.
Yeah, you're not used to seeing it cut in the Skyrim female form.
Right.
Kind of body shape.
Yeah. But...
Or if you want to do a different kind of Lannister look.
Yeah, there's
here.
A couple different of the Lannister...
There's just the Lannister, like, casual wear, like what you might see Tyrion.
Yeah, it's a very Tyrion-looking thing. And you can tell that's a retexture of one of the clothing bits in Skyrim, one of the classic shirts.
But with added gold trim.
Yeah, it seems like it's got a little bit more, like,
thickness. We look like Tyrion from the back.
Oh, yeah, we do.
We do. But, like... Season 1 Tyrion, when his hair was real bad.
Yeah, yeah.
Just the worst hair I've ever seen on a human being.
Yeah, not great.
That had to have been a wig, right?
I don't know.
Because it was so...
Yeah, that was real weird. Or they, like, curled it or something. Like,
it was big.
Yeah.
His hair was big.
His hair made a statement back then.
Well, let's get out of this one. I don't like this. So this is our Night's Watch look. If we get into the light here, you can see... It's very basic, just like the Night's Watch, like that leather, that's it. They don't have armor. They only get the leather.
I think that's the Sam.
I mean, John also wore the same thing.
Yeah, just kind of like the dark
like the
black
long
leathers
flowing,
and like the kind of quilted undershirts and all that.
Quilted undershirt and then the leather sleeves and everything, and that's it. It's very basic. Yep. But the recruiter for the Night's Watch, I forget his name, has his outfit in here.
Yes, he does. And his, I always liked his.
Was armored, yeah.
He had like a nice, like kind of cool long robe to it with like the armored under, like he wore like the armored chest piece underneath the robe and
but
stuff
you can
like
tell
that.
It's like a status thing. Like the Night's Watch, they all get the standard leather quilted.
Right.
Whereas this is
one
like
of the rank
chain.
People.
Yep. Yeah. This is one of my favorites because it's so accurate.
It's scary accurate.
The Stark Captain armor, where it's got that, it's still got that neck piece,
mm-hmm.
but this one blends in so much nicer.
Yeah.
And yeah, it's like that. It's quilted, but it's padded.
Yeah,
quilt.
It's like leather patches, like hard leather patches that go
and
kind of
chainmail underneath.
Yep.
So like when the Stark cavalrymen are on their horses, this is what you'll see them wearing.
Right. Yep.
Like, it's a very distinct look, I'd say, from, like, the later season. I don't know if it was in the earlier ones. as much.
This look?
This one, yeah.
I remember this even more from the earlier seasons.
Oh,
especially,
really?
Yeah, like when Ned would go down to like King's Landing and then the people who were with him were all dressed like this. It was very identifiable as the Stark people.
Yeah, I forgot that Ned wore something very, very similar to this.
Yep.
Yeah, I love this. These ones do have a helmet.
Ooh, yeah, show that off.
It's that stupid Stark helmet.
Oh, yeah. Oh, boy. No.
Really,
take it off.
They really got the dumbest helmets.
Oh, God, it's a nightmare. Oh, thank God. Okay, that's
this
better.
Looks much cooler.
Yeah.
And what we can do, like from last episode, combining it with furs looks...
Oh, put a fur on that bad boy.
Really cool.
Yeah, the northern armors were just meant to go with cloaks, weren't they?
Oh, yeah. Because look how perfectly it fits.
Yeah.
Like, you can get that mod we had last episode, the Winter is Coming cloaks, and then just combine it with the Game of Thrones armor.
You're in for a delectable treat.
You are in, like, you can genuinely, like, recreate near perfect, like,
yeah,
this northern feel. Like, this looks so good.
Yeah. And if that was, like a brown or a black or cloak, that kind of matched it a little better, like, that, oh.
Oh, it'd be perfect.
Yeah.
And then... Here we have the Brienne of Tarth.
Yep.
From the earlier.
I would say,
episodes.
Again, one of the most iconic ones. That's the armor she had, of course, like through many, many until the recent seasons. That's what she had.
Exactly.
We're having a weird bug with the purple belt here, but.
Yeah, it's also the boots for her outfit. Like some of these have boots, but a lot of the boots are that weird purple color. So that's why I didn't even bother making them. So, like, the boots, just find a pair that does load in. Like, I went with the heavy steel ones, the heavy steel boots and the gloves. Those ones work. The other ones, I was finding that they are almost exclusively that purple. But
bandits, I call it?
Like, the diagonal patterns and, like, the cuts and the rust and everything.
Yeah.
Like it,
and, like, there's a little bit of clipping. But, again, like, to me, that stuff is, like... The normal game has that much shit.
The
wrong
normal
with it.
Game, but then when you take this, like when you take something like a cut above, like when it's so faithfully recreated, not even a problem whatsoever.
So and Brienne of Tarth is like a huge fan favorite character and everything. So there's, if you want to be like the big badass warrior woman, like what other armor would you possibly want? Like you want to be Brienne.
And then finally.
Last but not least.
Winterfell Cuirass. So this is...
It's Rob's.
Yeah, exactly. It's Rob's. It's the armor. It's that... Mm-hmm. It's the Stark armor that we saw before, but then just obviously since he's a lord, he would get armor.
Yeah.
He'd be more protected. So like he gets that heavy banded armor over the sleeves, the neck.
This is my favorite one.
Yeah.
I love it.
I think I love the Stark armor look. Yeah. Well, maybe not with those big
shoulder pads. Yeah, maybe you're right.
Let's see if they work though. I want to see if you're able to do that.
Oh, nope. I'm into it.
Oh, I'm very into it. It works.
That's very good. Mod creator, you did a fantastic job recreating this. Like, man, I'm blown away by how well you recreated these. And I know that every armor we showed was just like, look how good it is. It's perfect.
But we wanted to show it off and. Just so, like, I mean, if you're not going to download it or if you don't have an Xbox and you just are kind of watching, like, we wanted to go through each and every one of those. I don't think we've ever done each and every variant before, but these are so faithfully recreated that it would be a shame to not show off all of them.
Yeah, so to the mod creator, I send my regards.
Adieu. We say goodbye because we're going to kill you.
Well, I thought we were going to go to a mod number two.
Yes, so we bid you adieu.
And do we kill the mod? Do you kill the mod creators when we go to another mod?
All right, just to break up the showcase a little bit.
Yeah,
we wanted to walk around, get some fresh air.
Yeah,
maybe enjoy the brisk cold, and maybe bring it with us.
Yeah, let's see if there's any. Oh, who was that, Tyler?
I haven't the faintest clue who that could be. Oh no, it's a White Walker. That.
Yes, Tyler, it is the White Walker follower. Looks like we got someone already.
What?
Didn't we get rid of Nymeria?
We did get rid of Nymeria. You've been a good
friend to me. That means something. Well, thank you. I don't think we did much to you.
Yeah, I don't know. The one thing I'm not liking right away is that it talks.
Yeah, that's unsettling. But it does have the blue eyes and the kind of pale bluish skin with the white hair and everything. And this is a white. It's not the Night King or anything, but it's a white.
They did say that they would have liked to have imported armor, but when you use that model,
yeah,
the armor comes with it. It's not detachable.
Right.
So when you take that Draugr model,
right,
you can't really detach it.
Yeah.
Which, I mean, maybe a skeleton maybe kind of would have been.
Yeah, that would have been one of the lower class White Walkers.
But, I mean, look it. They've got the ice sword,
yep,
which I love. They use frost magic. So, you can get them as a follower. We have been having problems with followers.
For some reason, we're having issues with some of the followers, but.
And I think it's just the data that we have left from
other ones. Yeah, when you go through so many mods. But if you want a White Walker in your game, if you're
a big fan.
It looks
so, even from far away, the eyes are so creepy. I love it.
Yeah, it just fits. The Draugr model really, really fits for the White Walkers because it looks just like them, you know?
If we can look at the inventory. No, we cannot.
No.
But I know all it has is, I was reading the description, all it has is that ice blade, which perfect fit.
Yeah.
Yes.
I wish there was an ice spear or something. A longer one.
Yeah.
But that is perfect. The eyes, perfect. They've got that weird glow. And honestly, the armor, I don't think it looks out of place.
No, not at all. Not at all. Because it does have that
character.
Northern hardy look to it, which
exactly.
is because it's the ancient Nord kind of look, so it does have that old
I think it looks
cool. Killed, centuries ago.
The one thing I'm very disappointed in is the assortment of White Walker mods. This is the only one.
Yeah.
This is literally the only one. I was looking for Night King. I was looking for the Iron Throne. I was looking for so much stuff.
Yeah.
I was looking for castles. Could not find anything. Was looking for White Walkers. This is it.
Yeah.
So your options are limited, but I do like this.
Right. And there are plenty of follower mods in the Game of Thrones sort of canon you can choose from. There's pretty much all kinds of characters.
Tormund, the
Grey
Hound,
Worm,
Arya, Jon. You can get anyone.
Yeah, but we thought it'd be fun to show off the White Walker. So,
it's a check different
out
kind
of
follower.
If you want
It uses frost magic. It levels with you, starts at level 10. Yep. It uses the frost cloak. So it kind of has that effect of bringing the storm with it, which I think is perfect.
Yeah.
And then once the Magicka runs out, goes to the sword, and it looks super cool.
Yep. So if you're a big fan of the White Walkers and you want to join the army of the dead, there you go.
This is for you.
This is the mod for you. So Tyler,
I think the mod for us is the mod directly after this.
Let's get right into it. I've been saying that a lot today.
You probably shouldn't. You're going to ruin our brand.
Let's go.
That's taken.
By me. TM, TM, TM. You can't have that.
I don't think you can.
Dude, I think I just fucking owned Nintendo.
I think you just fair used the shit out of Nintendo.
Hell yeah, I did.
Yeah, what up? We're fair using everyone today. HBO, suck a dick. Nintendo, see ya.
Eat it, Reggie. Wait, no. Oh.
Oh.
I just had a sad realization.
No, get me away from this. All right. We are here with our final mod, kind of two mods.
Yeah, it's kind of two for one here.
Two for one mix of the episode of our Game of Thrones week, of Game of Thrones in general.
Yeah,
it's the end, folks.
It's the finale this Sunday. Tune in,
this
HBO.
Sunday on HBO.
Yeah, we actually have stake in HBO, so if you
could watch, it helps
please,
our...
Please, God, please
we,
watch
we,
it.
We invested
God, watch the show, please.
No, Tori, we're sitting pretty. We invested 10 years ago.
Yeah, we got in ground floor.
Although
and
that,
things are looking
whole,
good now.
That whole channel is fucked once.
Yeah, once the dragons stop funding all their stuff.
Yeah, once, oh man, once David and DB leave, they're done.
Nah, they're not going to leave. They already signed on for another show.
Oh shit, yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
But, how are they going to make as much money again? Never going to make as much money.
I think they're good. I think they're pretty good.
But I mean,
Tyler,
HBO.
We've shown off armor, but now it's time to show off some of the weaponry.
And you can see it right here. We are dressed as Arya, and that's because we have needles.
Yes, thanks to the mod Game of Thrones Weapon Pack. This is going to add a ton of weapons from the show and the books.
And I just want to look at the damage.
We have the thing, so.
Let's take that off just to see the base damage that we're doing.
If you want to be a nerd.
20. So they're not stupid OP or anything?
No, they're like natural-fitting weapons.
They're natural-fitting weapons.
And Needle is one of the most iconic and like just one of the coolest weapons in the show. So in the books, I'd imagine. So
oh, yeah, cool absolutely.
And especially with this armor, like just give me the wide on that again. Like, it's a good look.
It is, and it... Oh my God! Look how good that looks.
Yeah, like you just they made it adult size, so it's not super tiny. And because you're not a child, you're not Arya's actual size.
You're not a child.
Yeah. So, it's
and another great. Of Arya's weapons, Cat's Paw.
Yes, we
the
do.
The very famous Valyrian steel dagger. Let's see how this looks in first person.
Very, very famous.
Yeah, I mean, it's got that. It's got that perfect like gem ruby kind of.
Yep.
In the center.
Yep, and the nice grip to it. You can't really see it right now, but if you go, like, yeah, you can see it. It has the grip, and it's not like, it's not.
And it's got a knife like holster.
Yeah,
it's like a that's awesome.
Small
like a little
thing.
I love that. Yeah, the like handle of the blade looks so nice, and it looks so accurate.
Yeah,
that's another thing with this mod is it's just incredible detail that goes into it.
Yeah, I'm loving the accuracy of all of the. All the stuff we're showing off today.
So here with our northern armor, this is
what
we mean with our 2-for-1 mod here.
Yes, we also want to show off Blue Ghost Fox's BDYEB port. Stands for Bro, Do You Even Block? Which is going to add a bunch of shields. We're having a weird problem where this is actually the only shield that's appearing for us.
This is the only shield that shows up other than the plain ones. It's supposed to implement like the Targaryen crest.
Yeah.
But we're just not...
Yeah, and the other shields are really cool as well. They're kind of variants on the different holds, but this is Game of Thrones special, damn it.
We're not showing those off.
No, but this is, you know what? It's a good shield. It's really cool.
It has that. I love the texture of it, too.
Yeah.
Like, it's rusted.
That kind of rusted metal.
It looks
metal.
Great with ice.
Yeah, and then, of course, the sword is the second variant of ice, which comes with the armor pack. Some of the weapons are kind of duplicated. Like the weapon pack or the armor pack we showed off earlier also comes with a few weapons.
It like ported a bunch of Nexus stuff with it. Like they didn't just port the one thing. And I think that's the same case with Bro, Do You Even Block? Is they ported not just one shield,
but like a bunch of them.
But like a bunch of them. So it's like a compilation of them. But again, for some reason, the only Game of Thrones one we could build was the Stark one, which I don't mind.
I'm
because
okay with
it looks
it. I like it.
Super dope.
Yeah.
All right. We're in the Hound's armor here.
Yes.
Because we have the greatsword of his brother, the Mountain.
Yes, we do.
To show off. And this is a really good looking one.
Oh, yeah.
It's so big you can't even see it.
Yeah.
That man is so humongous. Wait.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, weird.
Whoa. So it only shows up in...
That's a weird bug.
First person sometimes, I guess.
Well, okay, that's the first time it's popped in for us, but there you go.
But it's a big two-handed sword.
Yeah.
And it actually does look kind of accurate, like that grating on the inside.
Yep.
Like it's... Yeah. I don't even know the word for that. It's like hollowed out in the middle. But yeah, you don't try using it in third person. You won't see it. Or if you want a cool invisible sword,
there you go.
All right, this sword and armor combo doesn't really fit.
No.
But there isn't an armor set for it because this is Sir Arthur Dayne's sword, Dawn.
Yes.
And it's got that meteor in the hilt of it.
Mm-hmm.
The texture looks a little cardboard-ish.
A little flat, yeah. A little flat.
It looks like a fake sword.
Like a little foam sword.
Yeah, it looks like a foam sword, but it's a big beefy dude. It's one of the most famous swords in Westeros.
Yeah, and from afar it looks good.
I like the hilt.
Mm-hmm.
I love the way it looks like when you're not holding it.
Right.
Like if you were just wearing it as like an accessory. So like if you had an extra equipment slot, like if you have one of those things where you can have a sword on your back and then one an extra equip slot.
Yeah.
It's a good look. All right, the next sword in the pack is Dark Sister.
Yeah.
This is the sword of a Targaryen queen during the conquering. And no, it was
Veneris?
It was during the Blackfyre Rebellion.
Yep.
And it looks really good. Like there's not a lot of
there's no evidence of it.
No, there's no show evidence of it, but like I mean in the books there's like detailed descriptions of it. No, like it's amazing how much detailed descriptions there are of just weapons and stuff.
But that's cool.
But no one's seen it in forever. It went missing. Oh, I love the partial,
like the little
sheath.
Half hilt thing.
Yeah, I love it. And you can see the bottom like pommel piece is really ornate.
Yeah.
And this is another Valyrian steel sword.
Again, just detailed.
So detailed. And the other Valyrian steel sword is Blackfire.
Yep.
Same kind of...
Yep.
Same thing. Went
Aegon
missing
Targaryen,
with,
right?
With Dark Sister. I think it was one of the Aegons. There's like fucking six Aegons.
Yeah, there's like nine Aegons.
Again, it looks kind of foamy.
Yeah. Yeah, it does a little. But I like the dark blade.
Yeah, I do like that. And again, God, that like decorative pommel.
Yep.
That the like hand piece looks really good though.
Yeah, it's
the leather.
Cool to like have these things if you're a longtime fan and it's like, you know, maybe the lore that you've read about or that you've heard about and
you kind of just
whatever.
Implement it
and
in
now
the
it's
game.
Like, oh well, I didn't see it in the show, but now I get to have it in the game, and that's cool. You can kind of have your own story with it.
All right, so we are dressed as Brienne of Tarth to show off her sword, which is Oathkeeper. And this is one of the better looking ones because it's shiny.
Sure. Look
it's very ornate because it's a very like brand new sword.
Right.
Like it was just crafted.
Brand new reworked Valyrian steel. Man, the blade is wildly shiny.
I like it. I dig it. I love it.
And this is one of
the
most iconic
the
ones from
is,
the show. For sure.
The sheath is very ornate as well.
Mm-hmm.
It's got that head.
Yeah.
Like, that is very accurate. I don't know if that's meant to be like a dragon or like a wolf.
I don't know. Like a,
it doesn't
I have no idea.
Really make sense.
No.
Like, considering
she's
who
neither?
It was. Yeah.
But. Yeah, but
I mean,
it looks
very
great.
Yeah, like that gold.
Yeah, pull it out again. I want to see the metal kind of shine. Like, rotate it around so the light's not directly on it and stuff. But like, yeah, look at how shiny that metal texture is. That's wild.
God, it looks like aluminum in the best way.
Yeah, aluminium.
Oh, why are? It's like we're playing VR.
I know, that's super weird and very unsettling.
Except Skyrim VR is
horrible.
The worst.
Yeah, check out that episode. Or probably don't. You'll just get sick.
I think we got just a couple more for you, so
let's get
hang tight. All right, we're in our Kingsguard gear because we have the other recently reworked Valyrian steel sword, which is Widow's Wail.
Yeah, this
Joffrey's sword.
Yep.
And this one is weird because it's almost got like a
the texture on the blade.
It disappeared.
Yeah, we had a glitch with it when we first tried it out, but
awesome.
It's good now.
Yeah, the texture on the blade
that's
looks
wild.
Incredible.
Yeah.
And I think this is because this was the smaller blade that was like it was funneled into maybe.
Yeah. A little bit like thinner,
that,
more nimble.
Another that decorative piece in the center of it.
Yep.
It looks really... I want to see what it looks like just sheathed. Yeah, that
the half
gold,
sheath thing.
Oh my God, it looks amazing. God,
these
are so good.
If only Sansa were here to kiss it. he was maybe the biggest cunt in TV history, huh?
Oh, he's so good.
Yeah.
He's so good.
Yeah, all the credit to that actor, because I never wanted to kill anyone more in my life.
Oh, my God. He was fantastic at making you just hate him with every fiber of your being.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, a couple more. All right, Jorah's armor, because we've seen this before.
Yep.
Jorah with the Dothraki sword, and this looks really good.
Yeah, it looks really cool.
It looks so cool, especially when you put it away, and it just hangs out.
That's cool.
It's very dangerous.
It's very dangerous. If you trip and fall,
you are dead.
Yeah, you're.
There's
going right
no
your mouth.
Questions about it.
Yeah, but it's cool to have like a very different shape of kind of sword or blade in Skyrim.
And I think it works like an axe. Yeah,
right. And it'd be cool if you have like a really strong bond with your horse in the game or something like that, and you wanna ride and behead people from horseback. You gotta do it with the Dothraki blade. That's why they make them that way.
Exactly. It's perfect for just doing a nice little circular cut.
Yep.
Like, you know, you really want to get the, it's all about the motion.
Right.
Like, yeah. When you are like taking someone's head. Through. Yeah. It's the follow through. It's not how hard you swing it. It's just the motion and the curvature. You know, you get that nice flick of the wrist.
Yeah. And then nothing ever feels that good again, you know?
No, no. And then you chase it forever. And you're just never going to get it back. And
Yeah. It's good stuff. But Tyler, what do we got? One more?
One more. One more. Last show off. And you probably know what it is. It's the most famous thing. Come on. You already know what's going on.
Yeah,
here.
Of course. It's the most famous sword in the game, and that's going to be Longclaw.
And this, I love. So this is the weapon pack version. We have a couple different versions.
Yes, we do.
This is the weapon pack one. This has my favorite, like, hand, like the grip of it. Like, because if you look at it, it's got that nice little detailed.
Son of a bitch.
Like the kind of like.
Oh, like the kind of like rounded.
Yeah, the rounded. The blade does look pretty good, though.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, my God. Look at that. The detail in that middle section of it.
Yeah. And the pommel with Ghost's head. It looks incredible. It's that one-handed sword. The sheath. Also very perfect. And it just feels cool to have, like, a very decorative, like, wolf head pommel on you. Like,
Longclaw's just the fucking coolest sword.
Longclaw's the dopest shit. But then we there were a couple versions from the armor pack as well.
Yeah.
So this version of Longclaw has the weirdest sheath.
Yeah, it's like
I don't
way
ever
too,
remember
like,
seeing
like golden.
But the
decorative
pommel looks so much better.
You think so?
I think so because it actually looks more realistic as opposed to just like a white texture. This one has the like
The grooves in it and
stuff. Yeah, the grooves and the hair going downwards.
How does the blade look, though? Okay, so still very decorative.
Very,
very
decorative.
Cool.
More decorative.
Yeah.
These
are both good. It's kind of like
these
a preference
thing.
These
are both good,
thing.
Yeah. I just love the pommel on this one more. I think the pommel has more detail.
Yeah.
But the sheath makes no sense.
Yeah.
But then
they're both really good, though. That's really cool.
One more version. Let's see where this one stacks up against the other ones.
Okay.
This one's called John Sword.
Yeah. And
I think the pommel looks better on this one, too.
I think this might just be
the, I think this might be the perfect
first,
blend.
Well, this might be just the first one again, I think.
No, this one is John. This one's John Sword.
Yeah, but where did this one come from?
I don't know. John Sword.
Okay, I don't know. I have no idea what mod this one is from. No, this is just the first one. It's literally just the first one again. Because modders will give each other, like, assets and stuff. You've been
it's
duped.
I've been duped.
You've been duped. It's the first one again, which means the first one is the best one. Yeah, it's the same.
I think it's got darker. It's got like a dark texture in the. Because look how flat that looks. There's like actual texture in that one. I think John Sword is best one.
John Sword, good sword.
John Sword, good sword. It's really dumb that it has the best one has the name John Sword instead of Longclaw.
But
it's the most accurate with the sheath.
Yeah, just go put like a slight enchantment on it and just rename it to Longclaw. And then you're good to go.
Or just keep John Sword.
Yeah. Oh, I like your blade. Oh, think it's John Sword. this is John Sword. That's his name.
Ah, noble name for a blade.
Yes.
But that's going to do it for us on this Game of Thrones
Tyler,
week.
We have done a lot of sort of runway walks here. So I think with John Sword in hand, it's time we have the finale of our Game of Thrones special.
It's going to hurt, but beauty is pain.
God, it's about to fucking end, dude.
Yeah, it's done. It's done. It's going to break me in half.
And then I'm done. Seppuku.
With John Sword. John Sword Seppuku.
Band name, I call it.
I set you up for that one.
Sure, you can have some credit, I suppose, if you want to. If that's how you want to do me. Should we kill someone with this to end
just, it? It just wouldn't feel right if we didn't do this.
Yep.
Yep.
That's a pretty good way to end the episode.
And let's go to the outro.
Thank you so much for tuning in to this week of Game of Thrones special episodes. If you have any mods to suggest or any questions to ask us, you can do that on Twitter. I will be at Lurking Lion.
I will be at Subtly Cool, or you can contact us at Shapeless Gaming. If you're into the Game of Thrones themed stuff, We're going to be doing one more thing once the series is over. Yep. We're going to be doing some, we're going to be compiling our like favorite moments or like things that we thought the show did incredible. Just yep. general thoughts about not the finale, but the entire series as a whole. And yep. we're going to be doing a podcast about it. It's not going to have like an hour long limit.
No,
so
it's going to be like
deep shit yeah. talk about Game of Thrones. We're going to be doing that.
That's
going
like, to be the place. Yep.
Next couple, like next week or like the next couple weeks, depending on when this goes up.
Yeah.
So it'll be coming soon. We're going to be doing that. If you hate Game of Thrones and you don't care, watch anyway to give us views.
Yeah, thank you. And also, I want to say, because we're going to be doing that additional like podcast style thing, keep the comments on this like spoiler free for anyone else. So don't, like, this is not the place to talk about deep Game of Thrones moments.
Spoiler.
We'll do a spoiler cast, huh?
Spoiler cast will be coming up in the next week, so keep it to your fucking selves. And I swear to God, do not live tweet the finale.
Yeah.
Don't ruin it
for
people.
You're an asshole if you do
that.
There's
an embargo. You have to let it breathe. Give it a couple days.
And it doesn't mean, oh, okay, well, the next morning I'll tweet about this moment. No, don't say...
First of all, why do people even tweet about it at all? Like, why do people have to be like, oh my God, that was crazy when this happened. Do you just want to speak into the ether that you also watched and saw that thing happen?
It's even when people are like, I'm not giving a spoiler, but they say something like, oh, Brienne, though, am I right, guys? And it's like, yeah, then the whole time someone's watching the episode, they're going to be looking for X character doing X thing. It's the most obnoxious yeah. thing, and you're a big pile of shit if you do that.
Yeah, don't live tweet. Don't spoil it for anyone.
Just don't tweet about it. Just talk about it with your friends who you've watched it with or whatever.
And if you don't have friends, talk about it with yourself.
Thank you for watching.
Thank you.
You are fucking my tight little behind right now.